Google has aimed to do something worthwhile with its first Pixel tablet by combining a standard Android slate with a dock that turns it into a smart home hub when it's not in use. Trying to create a point of differentiation for a tablet has often been tricky, with many brands focusing either on cheap content consumption devices or pricier laptop replacements. The Google Pixel tablet instead is positioned as a sort of communal family device that, when not being used, sits on an included charging stand and morphs into something not dissimilar to the Nest Hub Max. Let's take a look. Google stepped up its design game with the recent Pixel 6 and Pixel 7 phones. While they may not be the epitome of phone design, the attractive multi-tone colours and striking camera visor made them stand out. It's a little surprising then that the Pixel tablet seems to completely shun any of these advances, going back to a far more basic overall look that's mostly underwhelming. There are two colours, either with a white or black front. Both colours have a soft, almost eggshell-like finish on the back. There's a USB-C port for charging on the vertical side, a fingerprint-enabled power button, volume rocker, and some plastic feet that help the tablet from scraping surfaces when placed on its charging stand. A small cutout for the single rear camera and a set of charging pins are the only things to adorn the back. It's a really simple design and it looks perfectly adequate. The soft feeling rounded back and sides make it nice to hold, and at 493 grams, slightly less than the OnePlus Pad, slightly more than the iPad 10, it's light and comfortable. The screen is more of the same. It's good, but nothing you won't find elsewhere at this price range. The highlight of the 10.95 inch panel is that sharp 2560 by 1600 resolution, which renders photos, videos, and text very crisply. It's a decent LCD with good color reproduction, but it's certainly lacking in some of the more high-end areas. The locked 60Hz refresh rate, for instance, gives it a jittery look when swiping that isn't there on the 144Hz OnePlus Pad. I also struggle with the display's brightness. It's fine when used inside, but on occasions I took it outside, the overly reflective screen made it virtually impossible to use. Even when sat beside a window, the screen was often hard to see. The Pixel tablet includes a charging speaker dock, setting it apart from competitors like Samsung, OnePlus, and Apple. The dock is a sturdy fabric-covered block with a magnetic top, allowing the tablet to charge while audio plays through the built-in speakers. When docked, the tablet enters hub mode, offering access to smart home controls, Google Assistant, and various screensavers. The UI is similar to Nest Hub devices, but less feature-rich. The audio quality of the speaker is not the best, lacking bass and struggling with instrument-heavy songs. However, it suffices for basic audio needs, like streaming radio and podcasts, with clear vocals and more details than the tablet's own audio. The Pixel tablet is powered by the Tensor G2 chipset, found in various Google devices. It has 8GB of RAM and either 128 or 256GB of storage without expandable storage. The tablet performs well in benchmarks, comparable to the OnePlus Pad. Gaming is smooth and the tablet stays cool even during intense sessions. It features two speakers, providing a decent stereo sound quality, and the 16:10 aspect ratio further enhances the content watching experience. Android tablet software has limitations, lacking tablet versions of popular pro-level apps available on the iPad. However, there are plenty of tablet-optimized apps available, including Google's own and third-party services like Netflix and Disney+. The Pixel launcher on Android 13 offers a fluid tablet UI with multitasking features, focusing on simplicity over productivity. The tablet lacks keyboard cases and pen accessories, further emphasizing its non-productivity nature. The Pixel tablet doesn't include a standard charger and relies on the speaker dock or your own USB-C cable for charging. It would have been nice to see a USB-C to USB-C cable included in the box considering the price, but there we are. However, I didn't need to use the cable charging often because I could conveniently attach the tablet to the dock when not in use. The tablet always comes with a dock, and additional docks can be purchased separately. The battery life is typical for an 11-inch tablet, lasting a few days with multi-hour use and losing minimal power when idle. Streaming an hour of Netflix depleted the battery by 14%, slightly higher than expected, but increasing the brightness improved viewing comfort. Light gaming for 30 minutes consumes 7% of the battery, similar to the OnePlus Pad. Charging with the 15-watt dock is slow, taking several hours for a full charge. However, the dock is designed for extended charging periods while the tablet rests on it. Google has added a charging limit option to prevent battery harm from continuous charging over time. Using a separate charger designed for Pixel phones, it took 160 minutes for a full charge. A 30-minute charge only increased the battery by 22%, slower compared to the OnePlus Pad's faster charging capabilities. The Pixel tablet offers unique features like the hub functionality and an included charging dock, but it doesn't significantly advance Android tablets. It's a good device for content consumption with a sharp display and appealing software. However, it faces tough competition. For media watching, the more affordable Amazon Fire Max 11 is a good option. Samsung's Tab S8 series offers better productivity features, and the OnePlus Pad is cheaper with a superior 144Hz display and accessory support. The price difference between the US and the UK markets makes it hard to recommend the Pixel tablet over an iPad in the UK. In the US, it competes with the iPad 10, but in the UK, it's £100 more expensive. With that extra £100, you could buy a better sounding speaker than the charging dock. Considering Google's history with Pixel phones, I have a hope that the Pixel Tablet 2 will address some of these issues. Hopefully, it arrives soon. So that's the Google Pixel Tablet. What do you think? Let me know in the comments, and I'll see you next time.